Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. This one has been long awaited, I guess. So today I'll be showing you how to install Magisk and get that kind of bypass the safety net thing going on as well. So we can use Android Pay, and I guess you could play Pokemon Go if you really wanted to still on a rooted device here using Magisk. So there are two ways about installing this. I haven't really explained what Magisk is, but from a previous video I did, it allows system-based mods to become systemless using their like Magic Mount. TM. So it's not really trademarked, I don't think, but that's about the basics of it. You can read a little bit more on the XDA developers thread here, but I'm just going to go on through the installation because it is a little bit long and I'm going to be doing it the longer way so we can get that Android Pay and like safety net functionality back. So I'm going to explain what I have here currently is just a generally rooted Nexus 6P running the latest version of SuperSU. And that likes to rotate. Yes, yeah, so the latest version of SuperSU, and it's working all fine and dandy. So I'm going to convert this, I guess you could say, to the PHS super user and using Magisk and all that, which gives us a lot of good stuff. But if you don't really plan on using Android Pay or anything like that, you can actually just install the Magisk Manager app, the APK, on your device here. And then with the existing root access that you've got here, you can install Magisk just by itself without kind of changing everything. But I'm gonna do the long way, the changing way, just so we can have a look at Android Pay and all that, and how it bypasses safety net checks. Because now safety net checks for a unlocked bootloader as well, and not just root access, among other things as well. So to get started, we're gonna have to download a few things and get things set up essentially. So heading over to our computer, just heads up, I'm on the latest version of Android, and it doesn't really matter, which is the NMF26F build. It shouldn't really matter what version of Android you're on, it only really matters for one bit, which is where we're going to download the factory image to kind of restore our device to a factory state. So this includes flashing the boot image, the system image, and the vendor image just in case, but really the boot and the system image is what we are going to have a look at, but in case you installed some themes or something like that to do with the vendor image or the vendor partition, I'm going to flash that as well, just to be safe. So here it is, the Magisk page. We're on version 9 here, last updated about a month ago, and we are going to go down to the downloads. The instructions I'll show you, it really is quite simple. We're going to use the version 9 link, so you're going to download the first two. You want the uninstaller as well, just in case. And we also need the Magisk Manager APK. So once you have those three downloaded, you also want to make sure you want to download the latest version of PHS SuperUser, which you can find in this line here. So we can open that up in a new tab and scroll down and download the latest one down here. I think it's R266-2. Just download that zip. You can see I have most of it here already, the four files that we've downloaded here. And lastly, we're going to download the factory image that is most suitable for our device. So I'm going to head back over to our device, and just so we can check which version of Android we are on. Of course, we are on the NMF26F, says down here. So if you don't really want to upgrade, say, to this build, and you have the older one, say 7.0, that is completely fine as well. Just download the one for 7.0 on the Google factory image page on this website here. So I'm going to scroll down all the way to Angler for Nexus 6P, and I'm going to download the correct one for what I'm currently running, which is the NMF26F build. So click on this boot link. You probably already have this, but if not, just download it. It's about, I think it was about 1.6 gigabytes. But download the one that matches your build currently right now, unless you plan on updating and then doing this. So download the version of the factory image that you are currently on, and once you have that downloaded, you should have 5 files here on your device. Oh, sorry, downloaded. So what we want to do is actually copy a few of these onto our device, mainly the Magisk Manager APK. We want the Magisk Uninstaller, Magisk version 9, and PHS SuperUser. So these 4 files that we want to copy over to our device. And I almost forgot to mention that you will want to have the fastboot environment set up on your computer already. Now, so you can do this on a whatever computer you're on, really. I've covered all three of the, I guess, major operating systems, you could say. You can find the playlist down below and just select the video that you need. It's in the description labeled as, I think, installing the Android platform tools. So that's ADB and Fastboot. So you'll need that as well. Okay, so I've got my device plugged in. So all we have to do now is go down and tap on USB charging for this device to transferring files. And in a second, we should see it pop back up on our computer. If not, I'm just going to open it up, a new window. And I'm going to make a new folder just to make this a little bit cleaner. Name it Magisk. Completely optional, of course. You don't have to do this, but I shall do it anyway. We'll give it a sec to write itself on. It does take a little while for some reason. There we are. I'm going to open that folder and I'm going to copy those four files that we talked about. So I'm just going to repeat them again. It's the Magisk Manager APK. It is then the Magisk Uninstaller. Then we have the actual Magisk. And then we have PWH's Super User for Magisk, of course. Now, once you have all those four files downloaded and copied to our device, as you can see here, we can now reboot back into the bootloader. We can flash our factory image to restore our phone to a more of a normal state. So I'm going to power off, and we're going to disconnect the USB cable as well to make this a little bit easier to do. Just hold on to it because we're going to be using it quite soon. Now, the reason I'm going to flash the factory images is because I feel that is the best way of doing it. I've already done a video like this before. This is the second take, and I figured that if you kind of flash the stock factory images before doing this, you'll have a greater chance of being able to use Android Pay without any problems, and I've tested this out before. So we're going to hold power and volume down until we get into the bootloader. And once we're in, we're going to plug back the USB cable like so. There we are. Now, once it's in the bootloader, we're going to go back to our computer now, and this is where all the fun stuff happens. So I'm just going to shrink my phone a little bit. There we go. And then I'm going to open up my command prompt window. Now, if you've set this up the same way I have in my previous video, then this is what you can do exactly. But whichever way you can use to get Fastboot working, then use that way. But if you haven't got this set up, feel free to follow my videos linked down below in that playlist, and that'll get you up to scratch in using all this. So next up, we're going to have to extract some images from our factory image. So we're going to open this up, and we're going to open up the Angular folder. We're going to open up the image zip file, the first one up here. Now, this will extract it to a temporary directory, so it might take a little bit longer, but this one seems to be going quite fast. So I'm going to be opening that up, and then we're going to be extracting the boot image and the system image and the vendor image, those three outside here. Now, this will take just a little bit longer, I think, not too long. And then we can start the flashing process. So this will, of course, temporarily unroot your device. You will need to set up root permissions for each of your apps again. And this will also, this will leave TWRP as it is. My computer is pretty fast now. We'll leave TWRP as is, because we're just gonna reboot into that straight away without booting up our device using the stock boot image. And from there, we're going to flash Magisk. And of course, you won't lose any data because we're not flashing the user data or anything like that. No need for a factory reset, but it is important before we start is to, if you want to, go into TWRP and make a device backup. The one that covers the boot image, the system image, and the data partition. So that will at least keep your apps and all that. So you can restore them instantly. But before you do that, you will want to remove your fingerprint or any lock screen security on there. So if you've got a pattern or passcode, you want to remove that before making a TWRP backup. If you're okay with potentially losing things on your device, or if you already made a backup, then I guess we can continue with this. So first up, I'm going to just move this up a little bit so we can see things a little bit better. So I'm going to flash the boot image first, and that is done by typing fastboot flash boot, leave a space after the boot, drag in our boot image, and then hit enter. So you can do this on any operating system as long as you've got fastboot working. So next up, once we flash the boot image, we're going to flash the system image. So we're going to type in fastboot, the action, which is flash, the partition, or where it's going to go, which is the system partition, leave a space on the end, and we're going to specify the file that we didn't want to flash, the system image, which is 2.62 gigabytes. Now this will probably take a minute or two, so I'll fast forward this, and then we're going to flash the vendor image. Okie dokie, so we've just finished flashing the system image. So up next we're going to flash the vendor image here. So I'm going to type in fastboot flash vendor, and then leave a space after vendor, and then we're going to drag in our vendor image and hit enter. This won't take nearly as long as flashing the system image, but a little bit of a wait, but that's fine. So now that we've done, we go to the exciting part, installing Magisk. So we're going to select reboot into the recovery mode, press power to select that. And once this boots into TWRP, we can go ahead and flash Magisk and then PWH's super user using Magisk. And then once we boot up, we're going to have a look at the Magisk manager and have a look at its, they call it Magisk hide, which is kind of like hiding root access from certain apps built into it essentially. Here we can keep this read-only, we'll do that, that doesn't really change anything, because a script can still, well, when you flash a zip, the script inside can actually mount the system image as read and write, and actually write to it. So just be careful when flashing things, that doesn't necessarily stop anything. This is a little bit bright, but hopefully you can still see what I'm doing. Previously, we copied the files to the Magisk folder on our device, so here it is. Depending on where you copied it, you'll find it wherever it is. So we're going to flash the Magisk, just Magisk first. Swipe to confirm flash. Shouldn't take too long. This will, of course, patch the boot image and make a backup of the old one, I think. Okay, so it is done now. We're going to hit the back button here, then we're going to flash the PWH's super user Magisk as well. We're going to swipe to flash that. It's going to go through very quickly. And once that is done, all we need to do is reboot the system. We're pressing that reboot button. Now we have to wait for our device to fully turn on, and then we're going to check out the safety net first, and maybe Android Pay to see if it can at least open up, because usually it will tell you that your ROM or your device is not currently supported, and it will tell you that is because you're running a custom ROM, or you are have an unlocked bootloader, or you are rooted. So hopefully this boot up sequence doesn't actually take too long. I think that's almost done. Well, one part of it at least. It shouldn't take too long. And it's not like it has to set up the entire device again or anything like that. So it is should be quite quick. So I'll be fast forwarding this and seeing you on the other side. Okay, it looks like we're in. Android is just starting up, so. And there we are in, the device is on. Now, one more step that we have to do after this is, if you swipe over, you'll see that we have Super SU, but that shouldn't work, as we'll have a look. There we go, it's the SU binary needs to be updated. We don't want that. We want to use whatever's installed already. So to do that, we're going to download the Super User app from the Play Store here. So I'm gonna go over to the Play Store and quickly download it. Okay, so you can search up Super User. If I spelled that right, super user on the Play Store, and we're gonna download PWH's super user, this one. Tap on install. I'll provide a link to this one down in the more info, so you don't have to search it up. Now, if you open this, you shouldn't see anything, that's fine. There are more settings here to configure if you really like to, stuff like that. But we don't need that at this point. We're gonna check that to see if our other apps work with this. So such as Titanium Backup is a one that requires root access. So we can tap, this will be what it looks like now instead of the little Super SU prompt that goes in the middle of the screen. I guess this is a little bit better, but sometimes the other one looks, or Super SU looks a little bit nicer, but this one is more intrusive so that you don't just press accept or okay to dismiss it that quickly. So you can see this is working fine. Now, I guess as always with different things can cause incompatibilities with certain programs. So I guess you just need to watch out for that. But we're going to install now the Magisk Manager, another very important part. So down here in the downloads, not downloads actually, in the Magisk folder, we're going to tap on Magisk Manager and tap on install that. Now, before you do, if it says you need to unlock or unblock installing from unknown sources, you'll just need to go ahead and do that. Now, when you tap on open, this should ask for root access. I'm going to remember this choice forever now. So this can grant temporary root access to apps. So we're going to tap on allow, and you're going to see these green ticks here. And what we want to do to enable the so-called Magisk hide, so we can get you play our Pokemon Go or pay with Android Pay, and kind of it's a pretty good root blocker, I guess, a root hider as well for apps that don't want to run on a rooted device. Almost lost my words there. So to do this, you'll need to enable Magisk hide. So to do this, you want to swipe over from the left hand side and go and tap on settings, and then you want to enable Magisk hide. Now, if you want to use Android Pay or things like that to bypass safety net, you shouldn't have to do anything more except for a reboot. Now, that was the first mistake I had. So currently I have these apps to test. Just Magisk Manager there for easy access. We have Android Pay that we'll take a look at later. We have Opal Travel that does not work on a rooted device for some stupid reason. And Safety Net Helper, which just checks our safety net status, which should return that kind of bluish thing. Yeah, this one. So it can request it, but then it cannot validate it. So therefore Android Pay will not work. So if I go here, well, there it is. Sorry, if I press plus and add a credit or debit card, it will say that our device is modified or rooted or whatever, and we can't do it. So I'll have to dismiss that, and we'll go back home. And when I open Opal Travel, it'll say, for security reasons, Opal Travel does not support devices that have been rooted. I don't know, because it handles payments and all that. So once you have enabled Magisk hide, if we go back in here, once that is ticked, and if we go back, you can see it here. All you need to do is reboot your device, and then you should be able to use stuff that requires safety net not to be broken. So I'm going to tap on restart. I'm going to wait for our device to turn back on, and hopefully then it should work just fine. So I'll be back when my device finishes booting up, or rebooting this fact, and we shall see the results. Now our device is just finishing booting up. There we are. And we should be able to get right into it. So I'm going to wait for Android to start up and whatnot. Now we're back. Now let's have a look at the safety net helper. I'm going to run our safety net test, and fingers crossed, it should be all green. There we are, like magic. Haha, that's pretty good. So this should work for Android Pay as well. I was going to test out Pokemon Go, but I really realized how bad it was, so I uninstalled it. And here we should be able to add a card. Line up your card within the frame, very easy. We don't need to do that anymore. And now we shall have a look at Open Travel. Still not. That is because we are, in fact, well, kind of still rooted, if you will. So go back to Magisk hide, and then locate whichever app that you'd like to kind of hide root for. Now, no, you don't have to select Android Pay or Google Play services or anything else really to get Android Pay working. Maybe perhaps Pokemon Go, but if I just go, I should just search it up. If I search up Opal or whichever app that needs to be hidden from root, just check that little checkbox, go back home, maybe clear it from the recents, and then try again, and it works. I can scan my Opal card. Luckily I got my wallet here all handy dandy. And you can see it works as well. So yeah, this is it. Thank you for watching, guys. I know this has been taking such a long time to get this out, but I just figured out how to do it very easily, if you will. Didn't know what was going on with the SafeNet bypass, so I figured it out finally. So yeah, thank you for watching. If you have any questions regarding this, I might not be able to help you as much, but feel free to leave it in the comments anyway. Otherwise, you'll have to go to the XDA developers thread that covers Magisk and all its help and Q&A. And if you have any other suggestions, I'm probably looking to do ROM reviews, although it's not really my thing, to be honest. I just choose one that has some kind of functionality to it, and I flash it. I'm not really into modding it anymore or anything like that. So yeah, and other reviews and things like that perhaps are coming. Maybe I should do a review of the Nexus 6P. It has been like a year old pretty much. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll talk to you in the next one.